the bleeder? Repairing the pulmonary artery first.
Okay, good call.
So we're gonna repair the lung, find the bullet. We're just gonna take it from there.
Sounds like a plan.
Thanks for the assist. A couple of very important people who are counting on us.
How long do you think the surgery is gonna take? With two bullets and internal injuries? A while. I hate this. It's like being stuck in some huge nightmare, terrible event I can't control.
You know, the doctor part of my brain just keeps going over and over the surgery, calculating the odds. And then the other part of my brain that's just Mac's niece keeps thinking, I wouldn't even be a doctor if it wasn't for him.
I thought you got into medicine because of Stone.
He did not want me to date Stone. I was morally opposed to it. You know, he was a street kid, and Uncle Mac always had very high expectations, so here I am, not wanting to let him down.
And then there's me. I've basically structured my entire life around letting Mac down. But he never lost faith in me. I mean, no one is more proud of my fashion career than Mac is. He never turned his back on me, no matter what I did.
I keep telling myself he has the best two surgeons working on him. What if that's not enough?
Don't say that, Robin. He's gonna come back to us. He has to. Good thoughts. That's what we need to focus on. Good thoughts.
One down, one to go.
Nice work.
You barely even sound surprised.
Well, let's just see what you do with the next one.
Next one's right next to his spine, so unless this up, Mac's gonna spend the rest of his life in a wheelchair.
You're not gonna mess this up.
Yeah, that's right. I made a promise to a very pretty lady. I'm not gonna let her down.
It's so surreal. It's like no one's even here. It's so peaceful, like nothing even happened. What do you think's taking so long?
They would tell us if
Mac died. Yeah, you would, Robin. Because you're on staff here, but of all the years I've been a patient at hospitals, I realized they only tell you what they want you to know when it's convenient for them. Do you think Mac even knows that we're here?
Did you ever try to sneak in past curfew or cut school and then just run into Mac somewhere you weren't supposed to be?
You're right. He knows. He knows everything.
Not that we'd ever admit it.
Do you think you could go check on him, just make sure everything's okay?
I want to, I don't want to distract Matt and Patrick from the surgery.
Or you're afraid of what you might find.
I'll check on him in a little while, okay? It's pretty spooky around here, isn't it? How's Ethan?
Oh, he got through the surgery with flying colors. Any word on your uncle?
Not yet.
Well, I'd be glad to scrub in and see if I can help.
Don't you dare go anywhere near that operating room. And you keep your manipulative, home-wrecking self away from my family.
Yes, ma'am.
What's that about?
Nothing.
Nothing? Did something happen that I don't know about?
I hope not. No thanks to Dr. Niles. She definitely wants to help herself to your husband.
I actually just had a conversation with Lisa about being interested in Patrick.
And she probably denied it.
Of course. Are you familiar with that tactic?
Then she probably dropped some hints and tried to make you feel paranoid. Yeah, I'm not proud of this, but I have used that tactic once or twice before.
Well, you know what? She can't make me paranoid. No matter how hard she tries, it took me so long to learn to trust Patrick, and I do now. I love my husband. I'm gonna love him for the rest of my life. You know, no old girlfriend's gonna change that.
Do you think you and Patrick would be together if Mac hadn't arrested Patrick and forced you guys to stay in the interrogation room until you agreed to marry each other?
I don't know. You have to give him credit. Mac definitely gets the job done.
I was able to remove both bullets. Max hold his own.
Yeah, he's gonna be okay.
I know it. Thank you.
Of course.
Thank you.
I would love to take the credit, but this was my brother's show from the beginning. He's the one that saved Mac's life.
And I flipped a coin to see who got to visit you first. And I won. You don't get to scare the hell out of me. It's the other way around, remember? We do all the stupid things, and you rant and rave, and then we say that we know better, but that's not true at all. We need you. You can't slip away from me now. I mean, if it wasn't for you, I wouldn't have had the courage to marry Patrick. I mean, who's gonna tell Emma that she can never leave the house? And who's gonna invite her over for dinner every Sunday? I love you so much. And you know, it's because of you. I know that in my life I can get through anything. No matter how rough it gets.
Commissioner Scorpio is settled in ICU. I'm gonna check on him in a little bit.
Yes, doctor.
Here you go. Thank you.
I hear you took a back seat in surgery. That has to be a first.
Yeah, well, Matt did a great job. I was just along for the ride.
Oh, well, Ethan's fine too. Thanks for asking. It was pretty straightforward. Didn't take long at all.
That's good.
Unlike the first hour of lockdown when I was stuck with Robin, we talked about you, by the way. It seems that you've convinced her that you would never, ever cheat on her. I mean, that doesn't seem fair, considering that you already have. So, you know, why don't we just be honest? I mean, let's tell her the truth about our relationship.
We don't have a relationship.
Oh,